So, today's video was requested by a viewer. If you'd like to request a video, comment down below and it may be the next video. Now, back to today's topic. We're gonna go and break down all the equipment choices real fast, so let's get started. First, let's talk about base PSO2 weapons and units. If you invested into your base PSO2 units, they act as a good placeholder until you grab some NGS units. Now, if you didn't invest a lot into these, I would highly recommend to grab the free red box units, which I will link in the description below. These units are a pretty good middle ground that you can easily plus 40 and have a good time with. Now, for your base PSO2 weapons, these are a completely different story. Due to the investment you'll need in NGS materials, your base PSO2 15-star weapons with minimal investments are great weapons to use when trying out classes. These can save you a lot of enmeset in the long run in case you go deep into a class and find out you don't like it, which I've done 4 times now. Next, let's talk about NGS weapons. So, when exactly should you invest into an NGS weapon? Well, assuming you've got the materials, cash, and you've chosen your class, now would probably be a good time just to future-proof yourself a little. In terms of what weapon series to choose, it boils down to a very simple choice. Resurger versus other choices. If your other choice does not allow you to make the multi-weapon that you want, Resurger is a better choice. Now the downside. If your class does not benefit from Resurger's potential such as Gunner, you will experience lower damage on average. But if you don't really care at all about multi-weapons, I would pick any 4-star series that is not Resurger. Glisten weapons, I should mention at the moment, are a seasonal weapon which have some niche uses, but overall I would probably just invest in any other series in the long run just to save yourself time and resources. Now moving on to units. NGS units get more complicated, so here's a pretty easy breakdown. Red box units and Gion armor increase your damage. Vialto and Catalia armors increase your HP. Vialto gives you more damage resist, while Catalia gives you more PP. And Kaldi armor is a raw PP unit that gives you 6 PP. Now for your actual unit choices of form a set, you have to think about your own playstyle and what is more worth it for you. If you decide to go full damage, 3 pieces of Gion will give you the most possible damage in PP, however, you will have 60 less HP and negative 150% status resist to everything. So a good setup for general use might be something like 1 piece of Vialto and 2 Gion armors, or for someone more into defense, 2 pieces of Vialto and 1 Gion piece. Now, be aware these are just examples, so I will link in the description below a list of units from the Arc's Visiphone site for you to view and decide your combination. Comment down below what you ended up doing for yours. I personally am using 2x Vialto and 1x Gion. Also, you might be wondering, where do the free red box units fall into combos, which leads us to the biggest wrench in our plans in NGS. Preset skills, should you actually care about these? This is the question you'll ask yourself as you jam all of your resources into your weapons and units. Now, in my opinion, your weapon preset is more important than your unit preset. You will notice a higher DPS output by getting a nice preset on your weapons themselves. However, you should not bankrupt yourself at the same time when going for a preset. In the long run, if you get a level 2 or 3 preset from the market and you play the game on a consistent basis, you may see a level 5 preset for the weapon you like. And that's where this all falls apart. You may get a level 5 preset. Preset skills are completely RNG at the moment, and there's no viable way to guarantee them outside of praying to RNGesus. Yes, having 3 level 5 Fix-A-Guard Gion pieces is ridiculous, but the likelihood of that happening is extremely slim. So here's my answer that I chose for myself when making my gear. Get a level 2 to 3 preset on your weapon and try to get any preset you can on your units. But if you can't, then no big deal, the game is still in its early stage. Having a plus 40 weapon in NGS units alone sets you up for the future of the game where things may be easier to obtain, or even change around. It also gives you a pretty decent baseline to grind faster for level 5 presets if that's what you end up caring about. So to summarize, use base PSO2 gear as a placeholder for NGS gear. Grab the free Redbox units linked in the description below. Invest into a NGS weapon after you found out what class you want to play. Use the unit list in the description below to combine what units you want to use. And finally, preset skills are a factor that you should consider, but be aware the levels of RNG to get the ones you want on the items are completely RNG. And that pretty much concludes the video. Thank you so much for watching and your continued support, everyone. If you'd like to support the channel, please like, comment, and subscribe. Today's video was pretty short, but I am waiting for Braver's Drop to really go deep into that. Also, I will be making some Final Fantasy XIV content along with PSO2 content, just in case you randomly see that pop up. Anyways, if you'd like to come and say hi, I do stream at twitch.tv/everydairy from 4 to 7 p.m. PDT every Tuesday and Thursday. You can find updates on my Twitter at everydairy. Thank you so much for watching, everyone, and I hope you all have a great day today. This is casual gamer Corvus from Every Dairy, and I'll see you next time.